Hi, good morning to one and all. In previous lecture, we discussed about what is rapid prototyping, technology of rapid prototyping, different methods, and what are the advantages and needs we discussed. In this lecture, we will discuss about classification of a rapid prototyping. Okay. There are number of classification. In those classification, there are majorly type of rapid prototyping technologies is the first one, photo masking or solid ground cutting. Next, LOM, that is laminated object manufacturing, in which material is filled by layer is known as LOM. Next, SLA, that is stereolithography technique. Next, FDM, fused deposition modeling. Next, LSS, that is selective laser sintering. Next, thermo jet processing. Next, 3D printing. Next, BPM, that is ballistic particle manufacturing. These are the different technologies used in RP technologies based on the classification of rapid prototyping. In those, that is liquid, solid, powder, in those classification, these are the major technologies. In these, in our subject point of view, we'll discuss about two techniques, that is SLA and FDM. These are the two different techniques we'll discuss given by the university. Next, coming to stereolithography technique. This technique, it builds 3D model from liquid photosensitive polymers, that is UV curable material, when exposed to UV rays. Suppose we'll transfer UV rays on those liquid, it will convert, it will create a material layer. By using this principle, we have to create a prototyping by using stereolithography technique. In this, we use the model is built upon a platform situated just below the surface of a liquid epoxy or acrylate resin. First, we have to fill those tank with a liquid epoxy or acrylate resin. After that, we have to transfer a laser or laser of UV rays into those plate, we will get a shape. Next, a low power highly focused UV laser traces out the first layer. Next, solidifying model across the section. Next, observed in this diagram, it consists of mainly, that is laser, next scanning a laser, next scanning mirror, next it consists of build platform, next support lattice, next vat of resin, next resin, cured resin model. Here, first we have to produce a laser from the laser, producing from that laser, it will transfer to the scanning mirror. Here, the mirror used to rotate the inconvenient angle, and it will rotate the as per the pattern placed on the build pattern. Based on those, it will move and is to move and rotate. By this, we have to create the model by using this stereolithography technique. First, we have to create one layer. After that, it will move bottomward, that is a direction downward. After that, it will create second layer, third layer, up to n layers. After that, we have to get the shape required, the required prototype by using this technique. Next, an elevator incrementally lowers the platform into the liquid polymer. Next, this process is repeated until the prototype is completed. Okay. Next, model is placed in an UV oven for complete curing. Next, observed here, in this diagram, here one arrangement is given. From this arrangement, it will lower the mobile platform into downwards. After creating the layer by layer, it is the in Z direction, it will move downwards after passing after completing the layer. It consists of laser source. From laser source, the laser beam will form. It will fall on the scaffold. Next, here the mobile platform is to move the completed layer in downwards. Next, here photopolymer resin is used. Whenever the laser is fall on the this resin, it will created a layer. Okay. Next, observe here. It is the object we have to, we are prepared by using these techniques. How this object created means here we have to place the platform on the platform. One layer is there, the helium, the laser is first transform laser machine to the mirror. Here the mirror is used to rotate, that is tunable mirror is used. It will rotate as per the pattern. It will rotate whenever the laser is fall on this material, liquid epoxy material, it will create a layer. After that, the platform will move in Z direction in bottom boards. Like that, the prototype model is created. Next, it is the step-by-step process of stereolithography technique. First, we have to create a 3D object by using the CAD/CAM software. In earlier lecture, we discussed whether it is ProE, CATIA, Unigraphics. By using those softwares, we have to create the model, and it will convert it into STL format. Okay, that is CAD data to STL file. That is formation of triangulars. Next, after this, we have to it converted into number of slices. This process is known as slicing. After the preparation of slicing, it will pass through the RP machine, and it will. First, we have to deposit the layer, that is UV rays coming from the laser, by using the tunable mirror. The layer is formed on the pattern. After the creation of first layer, that is represented here, S1. Next, the bottom board, it will move downwards based on the thickness of the layer. After that, we have to create the second layer. Next, up to n layers. By continuing this process, after the last layer, up to last layer, we get the required shape of rapid prototype. Okay. Observe here. In some cases, we have to prepare these complex shapes by using these techniques. Here it is the bottom board. Here the laser light is falling. Here it will rotate by using this. In this way, we get the material where the laser is fall on the resin. It will get the it will convert into solid form. Next, applications of stereolithography technology, that is, it is mainly used in medical technology, a tool, components, electronics, next communications, aerospace or defense, energy, form, fit and function testing, next tooling master patterns. These are the applications of SL technology, that is stereolithography technique. It is one of the rapid prototyping technology. It is the first invented, that is the first rapid prototyping technique. by using the liquid process. Next, advantages of SL prototype. It is high accuracy and smooth surface finish compared to the normal traditional methods, that is prototyping technique. Next, fine detail capability, wide range of materials with transparent characteristics of high heat resistance. Next, optical clarity, multiple finishing operations. Next, tight tolerance, functional parts, production to market faster compared to the remaining. It is the main advantages of stereolithography process. Based on these advantages, we will prefer this technique during the preparation of prototyping compared to the normal traditional. Based on these, we will prefer the SL technology. It is the an example of rapid prototyping prototype developed by using the rapid prototyping technology by using method stereolithography technique. In this prototype is created by using the epoxy material. When this material layer is formed on this pattern, we will get these shapes. Observed here in this diagram how there are a number of ribs and very thin layers is formed easily, and tolerance and appearance and accuracy is very effective based on this technology. Okay, next we will view an animation of stereolithographic process. Observed, first the laser is falls on the required trace. By tracing this pattern, we'll get the required shape. After this first process, the layer, the bottom part is moves in y direction, that is z direction. These are the mouse is created by this process and the master patterns. First we have to create a model by using the CAD/CAM technology. After that we have to create the tessellation process, a slicing. This file is transferred to the rapid prototyping machine, that is SL technique. After that the laser is fall on the plate and it will form a layer by layer and it will move downwards. Observed here the laser is falling on the trace generated by the CAD model. It is a movable mirror used to move the layer. First layer created. After that, this is the process. The laser is created the shape. Next, it will move at bottom board and up to number of layers created. The part should be completed. After the completion of this process, will remove those material from the machine. The bottom part is the support material for the build material. It is the another part developed by the using those technology. After the completion, we have to finish and clean the surfaces. After the inspection, we will get the results. Suppose any cleaning, painting. Here the painting is applying by using spray painting. These are the different products by using the rapid prototyping, that is stereolithography technique. Okay. It is about stereolithography technique. By using this process, we can generate prototypes very easily and effectively. Here the main advantages of this technique is it is cost the time taken to complete the prototyping very less time compared to the normal process. एंड इट इज़ वेरी एक्यूरेट एंड वेरी वी कैन मेंटेन हाई टाइट डायमेंशंस. ओके थैंक यू.